Welcome to Mojo Travels, and today we'll be counting down our picks for the most impressive feats of human engineering in the world.
Are you a fan of our videos? Be sure to subscribe to Mojo Travels and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.
For this list, we're looking at the most incredible man-made structures on Earth. Let us know in the comments which you think is the most amazing. The Channel Tunnel, Britain and France. Between England and France, you'll find 30 miles of extensive train tracks hundreds of feet below sea level. The Channel Tunnel connects the UK to the European continent and provides a quicker route across the English Channel than taking a ferry. You can still take a ferry from Dover to Calais and back, of course, but the train means that the high-speed Eurostar is able to get from London to Paris in 2 hours and 16 minutes. It cost billions, going hugely over budget, but projects like this frequently do cost more than estimated. After years of designing plans, construction began in 1988, taking 6 years to complete, and it still has the world's longest underwater tunnel segment. The Golden Gate Bridge, USA. It's up there with Empire State Building as one of America's most iconic and well-recognized landmarks. Its architect was Irving Morrow, who was himself from the San Francisco Bay Area and designed a few other California landmarks. It's over 700 feet high and 1.7 miles long, and has stood tall for almost a century. Though over the years, it's had to be modified to withstand higher wind speeds and intense earthquakes. And yes, it's definitely America's most famous bridge. Sorry, Pittsburgh. MILLAU Viaduct, France. Located in the Gorge Valley in southern France, the MILLAU Viaduct is the world's tallest bridge, standing over 1,100 feet tall at its highest point from the ground. That's extremely impressive, but it's also very long too, more than 8,000 feet, or 1.5 miles. A viaduct designed for cars, it's France's most impressive architectural feat, which is saying a lot when this is the same country that built both the Statue of Liberty and the Eiffel Tower. After years of competitions and debates over what form the bridge should take, construction ultimately began in the 2000s. It's a visually striking design that had to undergo many alterations to account for wind, and now we have an engineering triumph. Hoover Dam, USA. Straddling the Colorado River is the Hoover Dam, built on the authority of President Herbert Hoover in 1931. It had a joint purpose, not only of providing large amounts of power and drinking water to the desert, but also providing thousands of laborers with jobs at the height of the Great Depression. Many other construction projects were greenlit for this reason. Today, Lake Mead to the dam's north remains America's largest reservoir, and the Hoover Dam is one of the only positive things President Hoover has to his name. It produces 3.3 terawatt hours of energy each year, and was able to kickstart Las Vegas' growth into the popular tourist destination it is today. And in 2010, a massive bypass bridge was built across the canyon, an engineering marvel in and of itself. Great Wall of China. The absolutely huge Great Wall of China was built over the course of thousands of years, with various leaders of China building massive fortifications in various centuries. The most famous segment of the wall that you see in most pictures is the Ming Great Wall, built by the Ming Dynasty in the 14th century, and there were still hundreds of years left of constructing various structures. Today, the Great Wall of China stretches across the country's north, largely designed to protect the nation from the Mongols. Because of all the different sections, nobody is sure exactly how long it is, but it's definitely thousands of miles. It's visible from space and is widely agreed to be one of the wonders of the modern world. The Trans-Siberian Railway, Russia. By some margin, Russia is the world's largest country in terms of its landmass, covering over 10 million square miles. Russia's vast size makes it a difficult country to manage, with the far eastern cities like Vladivostok and the western financial centers Moscow and St. Petersburg separated not only by the Ural Mountains, but by Siberia, a huge ice-covered tundra. In 1891, construction of the Trans-Siberian Railway began, an operation that took a quarter of a century to complete. Even today, it still takes an entire week to traverse Russia on the train from Vladivostok to Moscow, making it the world's longest train journey, and it's always being extended. The line might even be extended to Japan. New York Subway System, USA. The US's most populous city, New York has one of the biggest, busiest, and most extensive subway systems anywhere in the world. Any underground subway is impressive, but New York's is possibly the most amazing because it has to connect four of the city's major boroughs, Manhattan, the Bronx, Brooklyn, and Queens, crossing the Hudson River and the East River numerous times. Construction began in 1900, and it was grueling, running into frequent problems and difficult building conditions. Expansion began right away after opening the first line in 1904, and today, there are 36 lines and over 400 stations. The subway lines have also always been electrified, in stark contrast to the world's oldest system, the London Underground, which was using steam-powered trains when it first opened. Kansai International Airport, Japan. The solution to the major cities of Osaka and Kobe running out of real estate was to build the much-needed larger airport out in the bay. Osaka just couldn't cope with the huge numbers of people coming into the city, so in 1987, construction began on the vast artificial island that would become Kansai International Airport upon its completion in the 90s. It took hundreds of millions of cubic yards of rock to build it. Not only did it have to withstand the motion of the sea, the wind, and the threat of tropical storms, but Japan is also situated on a fault line, making it prone to earthquakes. However, the engineering was successful enough that it's still standing today. It was the first of many sea-dwelling artificial airports. Palm Jumeirah, Dubai. More artificial islands next, but these ones weren't designed to house a huge international airport. Palm Jumeirah is a luxury tourist destination, up there with many of Dubai's famous locations, including the world's tallest building, the Burj Khalifa. Laid out to look like a palm tree, the Palm Islands archipelago isn't just home to exclusive resorts. Thousands actually live there on the man-made arms of the palm frond, made of tens of millions of cubic feet of sand and rock. It's being eroded, was built with awful labour practices, and has caused a lot of damage to local wildlife habitats. But the Palm Islands are a symbol of what humans are capable of, with enough drive, knowledge, and money to find something so lavish. Pyramid of Giza, Egypt. Built around 5,000 years ago, the pyramids were, up until recent history, the tallest man-made structures anywhere in the world. The largest is the Great Pyramid, or Pyramid of Khufu, a huge tomb, but also in the complex are many smaller pyramids and the equally impressive Great Sphinx. Archaeologists now know that the pyramids were built with a ramp and pulley system, as evidence of the ancient ramps has been found in nearby quarries. Just outside of the Egyptian capital Cairo is where you'll find the complex. And under construction since 2012 is the ambitious Grand Egyptian Museum, also in the Giza Plateau, which will teach people about Egypt's history. The Panama Canal. The first routes between the Atlantic and Pacific Oceans were treacherous. Because the Americas are so large and continuous, sailors had to either go around Cape Horn at the bottom, through the Drake Passage, or through the even more treacherous Northwest Passage in the Arctic Circle. In the early 20th century, the US wanted to circumvent this problem by excavating the Panama Canal, as Panama has the thinnest stretch of land between the oceans. 20,000 people died during the ruthless construction of the canal, something that shouldn't be overlooked, but the operation was ultimately successful. The Panama Canal is today one of the most important nautical routes in the world, connecting the East and the West. The International Space Station. Of all the buildings, bridges, roads, and monuments on Earth, perhaps nothing is as impressive as the biggest structure we've yet built in outer space. The ISS wasn't the first space station, that honor goes to Salyut 1, but it is the largest and most expensive. What's also impressive about the ISS is that it's always been a joint operation between many of the world's leading space agencies, making it a wholly cooperative endeavor. That's why any astronauts heading to the ISS need to be fluent in both English and Russian to speak with Mission Control in the US and Moscow. Located in low Earth orbit, it's been in use since 2000, after being constructed through many modules in outer space over the course of 2 years.
Do you agree with our picks? Check out this other recent clip from Mojo Travels, and be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.